Hello, this is Lazarus at telecomTech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining MPLS-TE label switched paths. I do my best to explain complex telecom and networking technologies as simply and clearly as possible. If you like how I do that, then like, subscribe, and enable notifications to be among the first to view newly published content. Label switched paths, or LSPs, are at the very heart of MPLS traffic engineering. An LSP is a unidirectional constraint-based path through an MPLS network that is explicitly established to route traffic according to specific requirements. LSPs are also often referred to as tunnels because they do encapsulate data and maintain the same ingress and egress devices like tunnels do. However, LSPs have specific characteristics that are unique to MPLS. So keep that in mind as far as terminology goes. So although they are tunnels, they're very special kind of tunnels. Now, LSPs differ from regular MPLS label swapping paths. Regular paths are established based on exchanged MPLS labels, which in turn are determined based on the shortest path algorithms used by the underlay IGP configured on the MPLS infrastructure. Regular MPLS paths simply use the shortest path determined by the underlying IGP without any additional capabilities of deviating from that path. LSPs, on the contrary, are predetermined paths that can deviate from these shortest metric paths. These paths are created and assigned based on many additional constraints beyond simply the shortest path. So unlike regular MPLS paths, which follow the shortest path as determined by the underlying IGP, MPLS-TE LSPs can deviate from these routes to meet specific constraints. As a result, LSPs can meet a whole series of criteria such as bandwidth, latency, and resource availability, ensuring optimal use of network resources while meeting the demands of modern applications that require high performance and reliability. So an LSP can be specifically designed on criteria needed for each customer, for each traffic type, or other network thresholds. For example, one LSP can be designed to cater to the needs of uninterrupted video streaming. Another can be constrained to deliver guaranteed bandwidth for business critical applications, while still another may be needed to only provide best effort traffic transmission. Each LSP can be designed to specifically deliver what is required, thus making networks smarter and more adaptable. Now, an LSP consists of three key components. First, we have the ingress label switching router. LSPs always start at an ingress LSR. This is the LSR that receives data to be sent. This ingress device is also called a head-end router. This is where the LSP begins. The ingress router evaluates the traffic engineering requirements, computes the path based on the configured criteria, and initiates the setup of the LSP. It also assigns the initial MPLS label to packets that are entering the path. Next, we have the transit LSRs. These are the intermediate routers that forward packets along the LSP. These are the P, or the provider routers, of the MPLS infrastructure. Each transit router swaps the incoming MPLS label with the next label in the LSP, ensuring packets follow the defined path. Finally, we have the egress LSR. This is also known as the tail end router. This is where the LSP ends. The egress router removes the MPLS label and forwards the packet based on its original IP header to deliver it to its destination. Now, ingress and egress LSRs are always the PEs. So an LSP will always start and terminate on a PE router. Transit LSRs, however, are almost always P routers or provider routers, but there are cases where PE routers can also play the role of a transit LSR. Now, the establishment of an LSP in MPLS-TE relies on the Resource Reservation Protocol Traffic Engineering, or the RSVP-TE protocol. RSVP-TE is a signaling protocol that communicates the constraints and the requirements of the LSP to all routers along the path, And here's how it works. First, we have the path computation. In this step, the ingress LSR calculates the best path for the LSP based on information about link attributes like bandwidth, cost, and available resources. Then we have the path setup. Once the path is computed, RSVP-TE signals the LSP setup by sending path and reservation messages between the ingress and egress routers. These messages reserve resources such as bandwidth along the chosen path. Then we have the label assignment. In this step, each router along the path assigns and forwards MPLS labels to establish the LSP. This ensures packets follow the exact route specified during the initial path computation. And finally, we have the constraint enforcement. Now, RSVP-TE ensures that the LSP meets its constraints, such as avoiding congested links or reserving the required bandwidth. If the constraints can't be met, the LSP system fails, prompting the ingress LSR to recalculate a new path. Now, this process makes MPLS-TE LSPs highly adaptable and resilient. For instance, LSPs can dynamically reroute traffic around failures or congestion, providing mechanisms to recover from link or node failures in extremely small amounts of time, on the order of several tens of milliseconds. Now, we'll go into more detail in how these mechanisms operate and how they can be configured in upcoming videos. For now, I'd like to end off this video by sharing with you some of the practical use cases that these LSPs serve. By enabling and defining these explicit paths, LSPs can support advanced traffic engineering capabilities, balancing loads across the network and meeting service level agreements, all of which are an important part of what service providers and data centers deliver to their customers. For instance, an LSP could be explicitly configured to provide 1 gigabit per second bandwidth and at the same time avoid links with high latency and can be instructed to take advantage of all available paths above a certain throughput threshold, thus ensuring smooth delivery of time-sensitive services like video streaming, for example. The ingress LSR calculates the path based on collected details about available resources and constraints across the links. And this explicit path is then established and maintained using RSVP-TE, resulting in LSRs forwarding packets based on the MPLS labels that are associated with the established LSP. Now, such paths can also be dynamically adjusted as network conditions change. Now, as we will see more and more in upcoming videos, MPLS-TE LSPs offer the control and flexibility needed to meet the requirements of today's high-performance, always-on networks. For now, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. I'm always happy to read them and to respond. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching. Thank you.